kiss you, and you had no sin. I hold it dear, I could not pay. I was bound to the grave, but you stepped in and you took my sin left me broken. You were broken for me. I was in bondage. Your blood set me free. I was a captive. Now I am. I'm made alive 'cause you live in me. Love lifted me. Love lifted me. When nothing else could help, love lifted me. Love lifted me. Love lifted me. When nothing else could help, love lifted me. Oh. It's only because of you, Jesus. Oh, oh, oh. I was moving. You called me. Lost and abandoned. Now you got. Born into sin, my soul set in chains. You saw my heart and still you called me child. Love lifted me. Love lifted me. When nothing else could help, love lifted me. Love lifted me. Oh, love lifted me. When nothing else could help, love lifted me. Oh, love lifted me. Love lifted me. When nothing else could help, love lifted me. Love lifted me. Yeah.
those who are celebrating their birthday today. Aside from me, today is also Russell's birthday. So a happy birthday to you, Russell. Anyways, we're already in the second installment of our series called Finishing Strong. Again, our heart is not just for us to go past through this year, but to finish strong by relying on God's grace. We are not meant to do this life alone, so feel free to share this YouTube link to your family, your friends, and your cousins. But before that, let us all worship God together. Allow me to pray. Father, I thank you for this opportunity to worship you together. I pray that each of us recognizes that we can draw near you even in the midst of our challenges. I pray that you will provide us with the strength we need to face each day and prepare our hearts to receive your word and to put the truth that we will learn today into practice. God, we are very, very much excited to hear from you. We're here not just to watch, but to worship you. We're here not just to listen and be entertained, but to encounter you. God, we love you. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Let us all worship our God together.
Stone cold, my heart was heavy. You broke through my impossible. Freedom, my burdens bear.
Singing someone else's praise, I sing my song to you. My foundation built upon your name, I'm sold out to the truth. Jesus, your love is coming close. Your spirit's moving and I love it. There's power in your name to break the chains, cause freedom is here in this room. It's you.
hard to see it, and took me so long to believe it, that you choose someone like me to carry your victory. Perfection could never earn it. You give what we don't deserve it. Authority.
God's Word for today. We are now on our second installment of our new series called Finishing Strong. But before we start, I just want to ask you, how many of you guys appreciate that really, really cool intro we have for this series? Shout out to Kuya JB and IPKC for creating this cool graphics. So just a quick recap, our first character was about a soldier. Isa shared with us last time this great point. We finish strong by relying on God's grace while we fight the good fight of faith. As our series title said it, if we were to finish this year strong, we are not to just draw strength from our own, but we are also to draw strength from God, the grace that is in Christ Jesus. Our heart is for all of us not to just go and pass this year of 2021, but to be able to finish this year strong. Right now, we will be talking about how Apostle Paul likened us into an athlete. So if you guys have your Bibles there with you, or even just the Bible app on your phones, we will be reading from 2 Timothy chapter 2:1-2:5. You then, my child, be strengthened by the grace that is in Christ Jesus. And what you have heard from me in the presence of many witnesses, entrust to faithful men, who will be able to teach others also. An athlete is not crowned unless he competes according to the rules. Before we fully start, I just want to pray. Heavenly Father, I pray that during this time of sharing, you will give me strength in your words to deliver this accordingly, and that you will be by my side as I share today's word. I want to thank you for giving us this time today to gather in the comfort of your love and mercy here in our homes to listen to your word and the gospel. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Alright, so for a quick background of the text, 2 Timothy is a letter of Apostle Paul to a young disciple named Timothy. Paul wrote this letter while in prison to Rome. This was his last letter as he approaches the end of his life. Last month, we talked about soldiers, and today we are talking about how we are likened to an athlete. So this topic is somehow close to my heart because my dad as well is an athlete. And reading 1 5, where it says, an athlete is not crowned unless he competes according to the rules. So basketball is my dad's first love. He has been playing the sport for as long as I can remember. I think he's been playing basketball since he was 7 or 8. So yeah, he's been playing this for a really long time. And like what the verse said, an athlete is not crowned unless he competes according to the rules. I think my dad really relates to this because I can see how passionate he really is, because up until now he's still playing, he hasn't stopped yet. Obviously I wasn't around during his college days and while he was still playing in universities in the Philippines, but as of right now I can see that my dad is really passionate about preparing for an upcoming game whatsoever. It's good, you know, because my dad isn't the type of athlete that would, because you know there are some athletes that would use some illegal substances just to get that energy and just to prepare for a league or a game, something like that. My dad, he's very traditional, you know, when it comes to preparing. He would go like to the gym 5 times a week, sometimes even the entire week. He'd go to the gym and, you know, just proper strengthening of his body, obviously. And yeah, he's really hardworking. And I think the reason why it's because he loves basketball and he knows that this is something that he really enjoys. And so I can definitely say that my dad is, you know, an actual athlete. Likewise, when Paul was encouraging Timothy, as he likened him to an athlete, it was also on that same day, a clear call of perseverance, to persevere for God with an athlete's attitude. There are still some similarities between the athletes nowadays and athletes back then, but let me just share this. An athlete back then was required to spend 10 months in preparatory training before the contest. 10 months. Imagine that. During this time, he had to engage in the prescribed exercises and live a strictly separated life in regard to the ordinary and lawful pursuits of life. And he was placed on a rigid diet. We're talking about real rigid diet. Should he break training rules, he would be disqualified, barred even from engaging in the athletic contest. As an athlete who competes, he must deny himself or himself, endure hardship, and persevere to the end. So must every spiritual athlete. And what a great encouragement again, right? The same with what Issa had shared the other month. Paul encouraged Timothy as he likened him to a soldier. And now he is using another character to give a clear picture to Timothy as of what it's like to follow God. But both have the same way. It is not easy. It is literally not a walk in the park, especially for an athlete. But then again, is it possible? Yes, and it's mainly because of the grace that God has given us. But let me ask you this question. Why would I even choose to do that? Why would I even consider to deny myself, endure hardship, and even persevere to the very end? Okay. How many of us here experienced asking this question? Lord, my family is following you. I am following you. But how come those who don't follow you seem to be more progressing in their life? They seem to be more blessed than I am. So why would I even consider to persevere to the end? You see, all these questions are valid. It is totally okay to ask these questions. I would even encourage you to voice these out in your life group so that they can help you process these questions. In fact, if you're here joining us right now and you haven't been joining your life group for a while or your group hasn't been meeting for quite some time, our encouragement, just like last month, is for us to be together. So going back to our main question, why would I even choose to do that? Why would I even choose to follow these rules? Let me focus on this part of the verse then. Unless he competes according to the rules. Today, I'll be sharing two extremes when we talk about rules and one main truth that I would like to share with you all. So, extreme number one, I don't need rules. Rules are just existing to prevent me from enjoying life. Just by saying this line, I know that a lot of us, one way or another, we thought of this each time our parents would give us curfews, probably. Each time we are told to finish our homework right away, and you know, when they tell us to stop using our phones and to not go on social media, right? I'm not saying that it's you, but I'm just saying. Rules exist to prevent me from enjoying life. It's false. Let me give you a quick example. I know you guys are familiar with these games, right? Axie, Valorant, Mobile Legends. See, if there are no rules in these games, I'm sure it will be chaotic. Like, 100% sure. This will not be a fun game to play with. If all that is in this games are players play according to what they want and, you know, just them having their own rules, it would not be a fun game to play. Yes, it's true, competing according to the rules is not easy, no doubt about it, but it also doesn't mean that competing according to the rules prevents us from enjoying life. So just like a lot of pro esports players nowadays, without a doubt these players put in a lot of They work hard every day, just like any other athlete, to improve their abilities, to hone their skills, and to work as a team and compete professionally for a prize. See, if there are no rules, their training would be in vain. Their training will not mean a single thing. Rules are not intrinsically bad. In fact, these rules help them and the other team to enjoy playing the game they really love. Likewise, the commandments of God. Yes, those are not easy to say, at least, but they are not meant to refrain us from enjoying life. In fact, the commandments exist for us to even experience the true meaning of life as we follow God. For example, the commandment, honor your father and mother. It doesn't exist for our parents to just have the license to simply boss their way around in their lives, but this commandment is for us to respect that was given to them by God, that at the same time for us, sons or daughters, can fully enjoy the relationship we have with them. Another example is like the rules that we have about wearing masks when we go out. They are not there to suppress us from enjoying our lives. In fact, the rule was there to even safeguard our lives and others. So for extreme number two, I can follow all these rules on my own. Perhaps you're in the other side of the extreme. Maybe some of us in our minds, yes, I see that rules are important, but nah, these rules and commandments are easy peasy. I don't need the help of my life group to follow God. I don't need to attend a life group or to even ask for some prayers from the people from my group or even my life group leader. And that, my friend, is definitely not true. See, just like how Issa shared last time, we are not called to do this alone. Yes. God called us to be an athlete where we compete according to the rules. But he did call us to do this alone, and God did call us to follow these rules solely on our own strength. Okay, I'm giving an example. In the FIBA 2020 to 2022 rulebook, there are almost 100 pages that a basketball player needs to follow. Imagine, 100 rules just for a basketball player. It's not even the rule for like the entire competition or league, right? That's a lot. I could just imagine how hard it was for some to go and follow those rules one by one. But just like how I shared a while ago, my dad used to play in his college days in a university competition. That competition is not something that he does alone. He has coaches and teammates to rely on. And in fact, even competitions like individual games, like boxing, for example, requires a whole team behind him to help him be able to play the game according to the rules. A whole team to help him compete in his highest capabilities. Likewise, yes, as we follow God, as we compete according to the rules, we are not to do this alone. We do not follow God's commandments solely on our own strength. There are people around us who gave us God to walk together with. You know what, fam? I feel you as well. Even I, who is sharing this message, is also feeling the weight of how hard it really is, you know, to compete according to the rules. And you know what? These commandments actually point us to the need of a Savior, someone who can do this on our behalf. That's why, through the life of Jesus, he follows all these rules and commandments one by one and gives that righteousness also to us, as if we were the ones who did it. That in our response, we follow him with all of our hearts, our soul, and our strength. I am so grateful that the God who gave these commandments is also the same God who helped us to be able to follow these rules. One main point that I would leave for all of us is this. Jesus is our champion who made it possible for us to follow God. In Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1-2, it says here, "Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a huge crowd of witnesses to the life of faith, let us strip off every weight that slows us down, especially the sin that so easily trips us up. And let us run with endurance the race God has set before us." We do this by keeping our eyes on Jesus, the champion who initiates and perfects our faith because of the joy awaiting him. He endured the cross, disregarding its shame. Now, he is seated in the place of honor besides God's throne. I'm not going to discuss this in detail, but allow me to focus on this part. And let us run with endurance the race God has set before us. We do this by keeping our eyes on Jesus, the champion who initiates and perfects our faith. Every one of us is called to run this race that God has set before us. I am speaking to all of us joining us right now, worshiping with us right now. God has set before you and each of us a race, not a walk in the park. We must run it, not to be passive, and it will involve effort and commitment. God wants us to run the race and to finish it right. The good news is, we don't draw strength on our own, but we draw that strength from God himself, our champion. Jesus is not the only author of your faith. He is the finisher of it as well. Perhaps there are some of us right now, because you haven't been joining your life group for quite some time, or you've done something that is not pleasing to God. There's already this shame or guilt that you are feeling that prevents you from coming back to God. But I believe that God's message for you is to go back home and let's continue to run this race together with God. He is not done with you yet. Our God will help us finish this race strong because he is a champion who initiates and perfects our faith. He's waiting for you. Come back home. Jesus is our champion who made it possible for us to follow God. Here are two practical applications that we can do based on this topic. Who are the people in my life that I can share my struggles with? God called us to run this race, but we are not alone. When we say that we want you to be part of a life group, our heart is for you to be able to find a community where you can share your stories, struggles in life, even share stories of how God has helped you overcome those issues and turn it into victories. In short, share your lives. Joining us in this Youth Saturday Online is a really great experience, but nothing beats doing life together with the people who really care about you and your walk with God. So we are really encouraging you to continue joining us in the life group. So the second application is, how can I grow more in understanding the Word of God? The point is clear. An athlete can make up the rules as he pleases. He must compete according to the rules given if he wants to receive the crown. I know that we are already in 2021, and it is possible for us to fall into the mistake of thinking that we can make up our own rules for our Christian life because, hey, we're already in this year. For some people, their special arrangement goes something like this. I know this is a sin, but God understands, so I'll just keep going on in this sin. That's why our heart is to ask ourselves, how can I grow more in knowing the Word of God? to be able to understand and apply these truths in our life. Because the truth is, God's word is timeless. A couple of practical things we can do, I'm really encouraging all of us to continue reading our Bibles. If we were to finish this year strong, reading our Bible and having our quiet time with God is one important thing that we can do. And this connects again to our application in number one, where we should also be connected to our life group. Our leaders who can also help us understand the Word of God and give us practical applications where we can follow and apply it in our daily lives. It has been a great time sharing this word to all of us right now. Let us continue to run this race, fam! Jesus is our champion who made it possible for us to follow God. Now allow me to take this time to pray for each and every one of us. Father God, we want to thank you for enabling us here from the beginning to the end. Thank you for touching our lives in ways we cannot explain. You have taken us to the realms of your glory. We want to say thank you. We want to thank you for the time you have given us today. We pray that we will intake whatever we have learned today in our lives and that it will not be, you know, something that we forget. We pray that it will always linger in our hearts and our minds. We pray that we will become champions not only in sports, but in our lives as well. We ask you to continue being with us. Let your spirit see us strong. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Thank you guys so much for the time that you have given us today. I hope you guys learned something and see you next time. Bye!
Thank you, Rakiza, for sharing that word to all of us. I just want to highlight those two questions that Rakiza asked. One, who are the people in my life that I can share my struggles with and how can I grow more in understanding the Word of God? Two questions that are, to be honest, very quite difficult to answer, especially when you're having a hard time. When you're dealing with the difficulties of online classes, your parents losing their job, or a family member who is not feeling well. But these two questions are very crucial in our walk with God. This life isn't something we're supposed to do alone. God called us to walk together with other believers. God wants us to get a deeper understanding of His Word and apply it to our lives. So yeah, we want to end the year by finishing strong, but we are gonna be doing it together. Gonna persevere together. But wait, don't go yet. Bye. Here are two announcements. First, don't forget to follow us on our Instagram account at ENC Campus Dubai and on our Facebook page at ENC Dubai. And for our second announcement, we're gonna be having our next ENC service next month on November 27th. Don't forget, November 27th, I encourage you to come. Same time, same place. On YouTube. 3 p.m. November 27th. Write it down somewhere. Anyways, that's all from me. See you soon, ladies and gents. Have a blessed day. Have a good day. Enjoy your day. Because I know I'm gonna be...
rising up, we see it all around. Jesus, you're the hope of every heart. Jesus, being broken, freedom's all around. Jesus, you're the hope of every heart.